What is going on, multiversers? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome to our multiverses character poll series, otherwise known as the Yay or Nay series. It's one of the best ones we got going. But today we got a very interesting, very different, I don't know how you want to put this, Jotaro Kujo from JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. He's gonna be given the spotlight for the series for the day. We're gonna see. I'm curious to see how many people want this one. Again, there's lots of fans of anime out there, and there's people that are totally against it. So we'll kind of see what the overwhelming majority of the community feels about this character. So let's start things off like we usually do with a couple possible moves for Jotaro here. First up is going to be called the Aura. I can't say it that fast, but here's how it works. First up, Jotaro will summon out his stand, is a Star Platinum, right? Pops out, and he uses this Aura attack, which basically it's a rapid flurry of punches. This attack could either, just deliver just a couple punches, but what if you also pressed and held the button? So, like, if you just press the button, maybe just a few punches, maybe like five punches, right? Just very quick succession, five quick punches. Each punch deals very little damage, but the more punches that you do, of course, you're gonna rack up damage. But if you press and hold the attack button while this attack is going on, more punches are gonna be thrown, and well, more damage is ultimately going to get racked up on the opponent. And that's kind of the point of these type of games, right? The platform fighters, you wanna rack up damage so that you can go in for KO, knock them out, get that first stock, and get the lead and stuff like that, right? So this one could be somewhat of a, it's one of the more iconic attacks, I suppose, from Jotaro and Star Platinum here, so this just has to be a part of the moveset somewhere. So just a big flurry of punches, and you can press and hold it to kind of like charge it so the attack goes longer, but you can also just press it once and it'll just be a few punches as opposed to, well, more punches. Move number two is going to be Starfinger. Now this one could be I could see this move being somewhat of a combo startup, a combo setup possibly. So here's the attack first. So again, Star Platinum is going to be coming out and basically kind of like points his fingers forward, and then like he shoots off some type of, I don't know, energy beam or something like that. But what the attack itself does would, if it connects with the opponent becomes stunned for a brief period of time. So this is kind of like a ranged projectile, sort of, and if it hits, like I said, it will stun the opponent. So compared to Smash Bros, just real quick as a better example, Mewtwo's down special, but that down special is a lot, you have to be really close to the opponent. This one might have a bit more range, but if the opponent gets hit with it, they get stunned, allowing Jotaro to basically follow up with other attacks, going for other combos. That's what I mean. Like, this could be a combo starter, a combo setup piece. This could be a very powerful tool, a very powerful attack in Jotaro's moveset. But again, if you're going to have a move that has stun capabilities, but it's also a ranged attack, there's got to be some downside. So possibly the end lag. If you miss the attack, then you're going to be sitting there for a little while, right? You got to find a good balancing point, right? You can't just have this attack where you can just spam it over and over again and then just constantly wait for your opponent to get hit by this attack and then they become stunned. No, if you miss it, well, then there's going to be extra end lag at the attack. So then basically the opponent is going to come punish you. So you got to use this attack smartly. But if you can pull it off and whoever gets their hands on Jotaro and really gets to understand the character can pull off some insane combos. And this, either way, combo move or not, this could just be a very, very good attack. And move number three, I called this move the throw. Yeah, it's a throw. I guess we could make it kind of a command grab. So yeah, I'm not joking either. I'm calling it, it's a throw. So here's the attack. Star Platinum comes out again. We'll grab the opponent and then either throw them, well, forwards or backwards, depending on, the direction you're holding the analog stick. So this could kind of, like, I know this is a throw, and I don't believe we've seen a throw button, a throw mechanic in multiverses. We've seen Superman do like a command grab, so maybe that's what this could end up kind of being. Maybe Jotaro summons out Star Platinum. Star Platinum kind of lunges forward a little bit and then attempts to grab the opponent. If they do, they can't block it. They can't do nothing. It is a command grab, right? So if they get caught in this, well, then, you know, they get thrown forward. And then if, you know, Jotaro's got some good forward tilt, a big forward smash, forward air, you know, just other attacks that can, this can also be somewhat of a combo startup. But again, it's a command grab, kind of like Starfinger. You can't have this be too powerful. You can't just keep utilizing this over and over and hope to grab the opponent. So there's probably going to be some end lag to this as well, as there should be for command grabs, just to punish you so you can't spam the attack. So it can't be super annoying, but you know, there will be opponents that will try this. But as long as they don't hit the attack, you know, if Jotaro misses this, then the opponent's going to have the best opportunity to punish him for that and follow up with something else. So the throw, this command grab, I suppose, could be another attack. Now let's move on to the alternate costumes. And I don't know much about Jotaro, I'm going to be honest. So if these have actual names for these costumes, I don't know what they're called. But first up, it's going to be the white outfit, the white coat and the white shirt and all that. So just kind of like a platinum white. I don't know what you want to call it, but for a lot of, I guess, Jotaro's alternate costumes, they're kind of palettes with color swaps, you know, just of the outfit and stuff. I mean, it's a little bit more than that, but if you boil it down simply, that's kind of what it is as well, because here's another one. He's got like the star on his shirt, and he's got like so many different alternate looks of, you know, just different colors of his, well, his getup, his outfit that he's wearing. So unless, again, I'm not the biggest person in terms of, I'm not that knowledgeable when it comes to JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. So if there's much better options, feel free to let me know in the comments. But I feel mostly alternate costumes, alternate skins for Jotaro is going to kind of come down to color swaps for the most part. I think that's kind of how the character works. I could be completely wrong though. And now for the, I guess my opinion, the portion of the video for yay or nay. This one's gonna be, this one's strange to me because I've not watched a whole lot of this show. I haven't seen too much of the character. I've played a game or two, but it's not a character that I'm particularly fond of. It's not like somebody that's at the top of my personal want list, so I guess just me not knowing that much about the character right now, I'm gonna have to say nay, but I'm still open to the idea because it could be a fun character. A lot of people talk about it. I mean, some for the meme, some really enjoy the show and the characters and stuff like that. So I don't know. I'm open to learning more about this character, and if they get into multiverses, I gotta give them a chance at least. So yeah, but as of right now, I think I'm gonna go with a nay. But that could change in the future, depending on, well, if I decide to learn more about the character or not. But either way, that's going to pretty much be it for this one. I do hope you guys enjoyed, as always. Again, leave your comment, yay or nay, down below. And then we should have the updated yay or nay stats, I believe, next weekend. Yes. So we'll see how that one goes. But that's next weekend. Today's today, and today's wrapping up. So hopefully you guys enjoyed, as always. And I guess I'll see you when I'm looking at you.